Hello, everyone. Adjust those rabbit ears and tune in your TV. We're going back in time for a look at your favorite stories. Stories from the hearts and eyes of our native people. Stories from the best of Heartbeat Alaska the last 10 years.
Everyone, and welcome to Heartbeat Alaska. This is a very special program today. It's called The Very Best of Heartbeat Alaska, The Last 10 Years. And on this special program, we take a look at some of the programs that we've aired for the past 10 years. In October of 1992, Heartbeat Alaska was born, and you were the cameraman. I got on the air, and I asked that to please send in stories, send in video from your village, and I will edit it and make stories for you. Now, don't get me wrong. We are going to continue with the brand new Heartbeat Alaska, in which I have a full crew of editors and cameramen that travel throughout the state. But in addition to that show, we now have this other show, a look back in time at some of our favorite stories. Like on today's program, I will be back with some of your video right after this.
Heartbeat Alaska is brought to you in part by Coastal Villages Region Fund. Thank you, CVRF, for your support of Heartbeat Alaska. And
by the Nature Conservancy of Alaska, working with Alaska's rural communities to conserve and protect our natural heritage.
Hi, I'm Mark from Scan Home, and we are proud to sponsor Heartbeat Alaska.
Scan Home, serving all of Alaska's home and office furnishing needs. Thank you, Scan Home, for making Heartbeat Alaska possible.
Heartbeat Alaska is brought to you in part by Brown's Electric Lighting Gallery. Thank you, Brown's Electric, for your generous support of Heartbeat Alaska.
Nobody offers Alaskans more health plan choices than we do. Maybe that's because we've covered more Alaskans than any other health plan. Primera Blue Cross Blue Shield of Alaska. We're here. We're with you.
Over the years, we have featured stories and profiles of some of our most favorite people, like this gentleman, celebrating his 115th birthday.
It's been determined that he was born in June, but the exact date is unclear. Mr. Northway picked the 10th of June for his own birthday himself. He has outlived 8 siblings and 6 of his 12 children. He has 38 grandchildren, 70 great-grandchildren, and 4 great-great-grandchildren, with 3 more on the way. Most of the village's 400 residents are related by blood or by marriage to Walter Northway. At this time, it's thought that he is the oldest resident of the United States of America. He is certainly one of the most loved.
We travel back now to August of 1993 to Saxman, Alaska for a canoe trip.
The Haida Canoeists began their journey on July 28th from Masset, British Columbia. The Indian canoeists arrived early Thursday morning after a 100-mile trip through sometimes stormy waters.
It had been 100 years or more since Haida canoeists landed their canoes in Tlingit territory. The Haida canoes were invited to Saxman for the Skulka family gathering. By calling from the beach and asking who they were, Phyllis Almquist was acknowledging that they were greeting the Haidas on other Indians' land, the land of the Cape Fox Tlingits, the location of the Skulka family gathering.
As long as you're here, we know that you're also under our protection. And as you go back, we know that the Lord will protect you once again and give you a safe journey back. We're thankful that you're here as a community of Saxmen. Our arms are truly open to you. As you come ashore, we're going to be singing a song, a welcome song from Cape Fox. Lauren Shield, nephew of a chief, will be dancing for you.
Again, in keeping with tradition, the Haidas acknowledged the welcome of the Tlingits by coming ashore with their canoes pointed backwards, demonstrating that they too come in peace. The canoeists paddled the canoes to Saxman to participate in this week's Thomas Skulka family reunion. Haida canoes are famous for their beauty and length. Stones were added to the 36-foot long and 42-foot long canoes for ballast. Hundreds of people were there to participate in the historic landing of the canoes, and for 3 days following the landing, the family reunion included feasting and banquets. Each week, Heartbeat Alaska brings you great stories from all over the state. And we couldn't do it without the generous support of Frontier Flying Service. Frontier gets our camera crews where they need to go. So whenever you see a Frontier plane, give them a wave.
Say hi from Nutset.
You might just be on Heartbeat Alaska.
Frontier Flying Service, covering Alaska for over 50 years.
Oh, yeah, oh.
You're late, Dad.
I know.
Almost done with my homework.
Yeah?
Tess is mad at you.
She's mad at me about?
You said you would play basketball with her. She said she'll never speak to you again.
Parents that are involved with their kids are more likely to help keep their kids away from drugs.
Okay. Nothing but that.
From Saxman, July of 1993, all the way up to Kotzebue, Alaska, for their trade fair.
The Eskimo have always had the food that they gathered throughout the hunting seasons and brought them here for bartering and trading.
So to give you an idea how much string fish we would collect is about 30 to 40 bundles. One string and collecting 20 strings, that's one bundle. And that's about how much fish people would collect.
Today's trade fair at Kotzebue is a way for the Inupiaq to share information about their culture.
The parka that Janice is wearing is made mostly out of the half backs and half bellies of muskrat, the inner ruff, the tassels, the cuffs, and the bottom part of the parka is made of wolverine, the shoulder, bottom, and back pattern is made of the calf skin. The red lines you see are felt, and the fine black lines, they're fish skin. Before we had the zipper, we made the parka a little bit bigger so we could pull the parka on and off like a t-shirt. The ruff is called a sunshine ruff because it depicts the sunshine. The outer ruff is wolf. And this parka was made 22 years ago for Vernetta.
Here in Kotzebue, it was the hub for all of the people including the visitors from Siberia and Yupik, the Russian, and also from Wales and Shishmaref. People came as far away by boat, and they lived in tents down the other end of town, where many times there were thousands of tents. And the elder Lena Sowers talked about the rows of tents where people lived during the bartering and trading, which we call the Northwest Native Trade Fair.
Omar Williams.
Today's Northwest Native Trade Fair is filled with traditional events and games, such as the arm pull, the leg wrestle, the toe kick, and events such as seal skinning and duck plucking, muskrat skinning. More games included the wrist carry and stick pull. There were kayak races and also the best donut recipe. The trade fair was scheduled around the 4th of July celebration. Although 4th of July is long over, we still bring you the parade. It reflects the enthusiasm and spirit of this northern community. From Kotzebue, we travel to Bethel, Alaska, featuring a 1993 story with Mike Williams and the YKHC Correctional Center. The Native Culture Club at the Correctional Center plays host to the community at an annual picnic. It's a time to get together with families and people from the community to share a meal and pass the time with friends.
We've been going out fishing for all summer. We got so much fish. Hey, Dal, let's be sober and go fishing. You guys can do it too. It's very simple.
Percentage-wise, Alaska Natives make up a small portion of our population. Yet Alaska has more Natives in prison than in any other place in the world. Alcohol is one of the leading causes for these lopsided statistics. The Native culture clubs throughout the prison system give the inmates a sense of purpose, one of which is education.
I chose to be sober, and my wife and my family gave me a choice, my family or my bottle. And I decided to choose my family. It was a hard choice.
Iditarod musher and sobriety advocate Mike Williams was asked by the inmates to share his experiences.
And I would like to have a strong family, and for the last 8 years I've been able to abstain from using alcohol, even though I traveled throughout the country. And inmates are very special people, and no matter what, each person that is alive today is very valuable.
Mike Williams speaks from the heart. Though sober now, at one time alcohol almost ruined his life. And tragically, it did take the life of loved ones.
My younger brother, had a chance, and he worked on his own sobriety, he doesn't have a chance anymore. But all the inmates, all you inmates right now, have a chance to make a difference when you get out of here. You are a very special person, and the whole goal should be not to have anyone at YKCC or incarcerated.
Hi, I'm Lisa Zam with Alaska Family Hospice, your home in the city. We would like to invite you to stay with Alaska Family, located right next to the Alaska Native Medical Center, We will have a new addition for our special prenatal guests, a beautiful prenatal home. Call to make your reservations. This fall and winter, every guest is entered in a very special drawing every week for gift certificates, and in December, a grand drawing. So the next time you're coming to Anchorage, stay with Alaska Family, your home in the city.
Jeannie Green Productions, Alaska's premier commercial, documentary, and event production team. Whenever and wherever you need video production, our experienced, dedicated professionals give your project the extra edge you're looking for. Alaska native owned and operated, Jeannie Green Productions, your complete video production service.
Now this story was an award winner from the Alaska Press Club. And it wasn't about the beautiful editing, and it wasn't about the beautiful videographer. It was about the heart and soul of this story, Nulato, honoring the elders.
Nulato was originally a summer camp. The ancient Indians in that area, called the Kayu, would gather on the Yukon River to fish and gather food for the winter. Then the outsiders came. A Russian explorer named Malakoff arrived at Nulato on February 8, 1838, after traveling inland and overland from Unalakleet. Other Russian explorers followed. Competition for the rich fur trade grew more intense each year. And in 1851, the battle known as the Nulato Massacre took place. 30 or more years later, the Sternwheeler steamboats brought gold prospectors into interior Alaska. Nulato has always been a natural meeting place for the Indians of Caillou Flats, Unalakleet, and the Koyukuk River.
Bless us, O Lord, and these thy gifts, which we are about to receive from thy bounty through Christ our Lord. Amen.
And bounty they did receive. On November 20th, the elders of Nulato were honored by the community. In the past 6 months, several elders had passed away. These recent and numerous losses inspired several village members to honor the elders while they were still with us. Treated to a sumptuous buffet and seated comfortably, it was time for everyone else to eat, and eat they did, preparing for the rest of the afternoon celebrations.
He chose you because he said he thinks you are special, because you are not.
Each elder was presented with the poster outlining what makes them special. The children decided this for themselves. Needless to say, there were too many reasons to mention.
Dad, they think you are special because you used to work at the school. You know how to build fish wheel, and you teach your children how to drive boats, snowboats, and you cut and pack wood. Traps. You are our grandpa, and because you used to be a great dog musher, you are a nice
to another profile, Bill Stevens. We all know him, an Athabascan fiddler, and this goes all the way back to 1993. Fiddler. He was born on the Black River outside of Fort Yukon nearly 60 years ago. As a child, he was introduced to violin music at a village potlatch. He promised his mother he would do extra chores if she would buy him a fiddle of his own. Well, she did. From Sears Roebuck catalog, it cost $25. Today, Bill Stevens is in demand to play old-time jigs all over the state.
But I fooled around with it and learned a little bit, just enough to play a couple of few tunes, and then I left for Mount Edgecombe, and I didn't play after that because there's a dormitory there, and I'm a shy person, and I don't want to play with all those other students. So I didn't play for a period of about 15 years. I went back to Fort Yukon and went trapping. And then in 1960, I left for California. And I was in California for the entire 1960s and 70s. And came back to Alaska in 1982. In 1975, I took up the fiddle again. Because fiddling was really popular in California, old-time fiddling and bluegrass and all that sort. There have been a lot of fiddle contests, and I played in quite a few of them, quite a few trophies, and proud of them.
Almost 150 years ago, Hudson Bay Company traders from Scotland and the Orkney Islands and French-Canadian travelers came to the interior of Alaska, introducing the fiddle and the traditional music from their homelands to the Athabascan people of Fort Yukon. The Alaskan Athabascans liked the music so well, they quickly adopted it, modified the sound with a blend of their own traditional Indian music, and produced what we call today Athabascan old-time fiddling. Over the years, this blend of European, Canadian, and Athabascan music has evolved and been modified by the particular style of the Yukon village in which it's played. The villages upriver kept the Scottish Arcadian influence strong, while the downriver villages favored the country western music that they had been fondly playing on phonographs ordered from Sears Roebuck Company catalogs. Athabascan old-time fiddling festival held every year in Fairbanks.
I can just tell by attending these festivals that the elders and the youngers both enjoy old-time fiddling and the dancing that goes with it. And it looks like it's going to survive for a long time. And I'm really proud of that.
On the Old Heartbeat Alaskas, we always had music videos. This is my number one all-time favorite, Kashtin.
Da-dum-da, da-dum-da,
Wasn't this fun? Stay tuned now, coming up, if you're in rural Alaska, a regular Heartbeat Alaska. If you're in Anchorage, we'll see you again next week. I'll be back in just a moment for the rest of rural Alaska. God bless you. Don't go away. I'll be right back.